So, my name's Abner, and I'm here to do a part of the superhero project, which is a project I've been working on for a few years now. And the project started, I was invited to do a class with handicapped children to do some videos, to shoot videos with them. And I asked them what sort of video they'd like to shoot, and they said, we'd like to be superheroes. So at that point on, I just kind of realized that, well, you know, if these kids think that they can be superheroes, pretty much anybody can be. So that was the beginning of the project. Then I went out and I had a friend make some costumes for me. And I went out in the streets and I started to just meet people and put costumes on them and take a picture of them. And ask them, most importantly, if they had three superpowers, what would they be? So the project started out just really as like an innocent sort of performance. And so that's the basis of the project. And I've basically been able to travel to quite a few countries and to meet just different people on the streets from all backgrounds and turn them into superheroes and to hear what their superpowers would be. So. And no one's ever had the same superpowers. I've never heard the same three.
Really? Which kind of superpowers do you hear often? The most often? Is that other
time? Yeah. Well, I was just on a trip in the US for 3 months where I raised money on a product called Kickstarter. It's a Kickstarter is like a thing where people can send money to you to a project if they like the project and raise money and then you can do a trip. So I was in the States for 3 months and I met a few hundred superheroes, and I would say the most common thing I heard was invisibility. Mm-hmm. And so I think within, as an artist, it's not my job to, you know, to think about why would you say invisibility, but afterwards when I go home, you know, you hear invisibility is a major sort of project, a major sort of theme. It makes you kind of think, why do so many people want to be invisible? Mm-hmm. So, but as I said, it's never really been, everyone always has different powers. I was born in Israel, and in fact, my family is Austrian. So I have my proud Preis, sorry. So it's very interesting for me to come back as well here. I'm very happy about that. I was born, then I moved to the United States to Philadelphia when I was 9 and went to school there. And I basically, and I've been living in Europe since 1999. I studied painting and I turned into a performance-based artist, and somehow I'm finding myself becoming a photographer. In a weird way, because I like to document the people that I turn into heroes. I also send them the images. You know, I give them my card and I say, if you want the image of yourself dressed as a hero, I'll send it to them. So, I do. I also, as well, I have gallery sculpture work, but this is my social-based work and I would have to do it just to feel good about being an artist. I'm a storyteller, and I do large drawings like a child, with markers and with crayons. And all my work is based on happy endings. So nowadays I think most of the art that we're faced with is a negative sort of message. So my own work is always based on happiness and sort of childlike emotions. So. That's my approach, I guess. Sure.
Well, as a street artist, I've been to quite a few places in Europe as well. And Vienna strikes me as being kind of distant. It's not a lot of street art here. There's some graffiti, but it's not like Berlin or a place like that where it's all so saturated, so I like it. It's easier for something like me to work. But it's also not like it's a very friendly city, it's not sterile. It's not too clean, which I like. I mean, the air is clean, it's nice, don't get me wrong, but it's not like Zurich or someplace like that, it's difficult to more. So for me, it's a good idea. I'm an artist from New York City. I've been doing street art since the late 1970s, which is what's unusual probably about me, just because I've been doing it for a long time. And since street art became so popular around the early 2000s, I get an opportunity to travel around to different cities and do different projects at my expense, which I really appreciate. So that's my a big part of my creative practice is traveling and doing my work. I also do gallery work because I don't make money on my street art, which is makes it very free and it's not responsible to anyone but myself. So I'm in shows like this a lot too to support my street art. So if I go to a city for a show, I would do street art for free and stuff with it. My influence as a painter is old master painting, like stuff in the pre-19th century. So that's what I, that's how I learned how to paint, that's how I, that's my medium is old master realism. But I don't feel it's interesting unless it has a modern context. And so I try to paint an old technique, very modern, anxious subjects, like some of those papers stuff. Has a feel of sort of spiritual illumination, but it's very modern.